It's been several days, several weeks, several months. Still no update for Tyson Fury and Anthony Joshua. What gives? We're going to talk about it. What up, Fight World? It's your boy Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. Make sure you smash the like button. Also, subscribe to the channel for the latest and greatest in boxing. Make sure you guys use my link tree in the description box to all of my videos. If you are ordering UFC Francis Ngannou versus Stipe Miocic, part 2 should be a great main event. I'm definitely going to be tapped in. It does help the channel when you guys click on that link. It's an affiliate link. Much love to everybody who's already ordered. I've tracked it, and it looks like it's an anticipated fight because a lot of you guys have already used the link. So appreciate y'all, and let's get into the video. Now, Tyson Fury and Anthony Joshua. A lot of cap, a lot of nonsense. And I don't know about anyone else, but I feel like it's becoming very cumbersome and tiresome hearing Eddie Hearn and all the parties speaking on a Tyson Fury versus Anthony Joshua fight with no real detail. What I mean is this: they've literally been talking about Joshua versus Fury for a year plus, and every time you read a new headline, it's the same mumbo jumbo. There's never an official update. There's nothing that gives you hope or a clue as to what's really happening. It still doesn't explain and answer the question about the Deontay Wilder arbitration, and it's just more cappage, more cappery going on in boxing. And as long as I have a channel and a voice in this sport, then I'm always going to speak what's important to me. And I don't think this grows the sport of boxing. You know, you'll see headlines talking about, oh, Joshua Fury is getting close. Joshua Fury, they're about to sign contracts next week. Joshua Fury, it could happen in Dubai. Joshua Fury in Saudi Arabia. Joshua Fury, they could fight in Singapore. Joshua Fury, the Wembley has a hope. They could fight in Wembley. When are you going to announce the fight? We got to get out of the culture in boxing where it's just talk. Let the fighters talk to build up the fight, whatever. That's one thing. But why do we want to hear the promoters and networks talking? It's about doing. It's about showing us. You know, who cares about, we could talk about fantasy fights all day. That's not what I get paid for. You know, talking about, oh, Mike Tyson versus David Tua in 93, what would have happened? Like, I don't care about that. What I care about is the growth of the sport of boxing. And I don't care about the establishment and the negotiations and stuff like that. So it's getting irritating to see all these articles with no real growth. You know what I mean? It's like I liken it to, let's say somebody is trying to lose 100 pounds. They're extremely morbidly obese. They're trying to lose weight. Anybody in that profession of fitness and, you know, physical health or whatnot, they're going to tell you to not stress your weight. You know what I mean? Not look at the scale, because the scale could be deceiving and it could be very discouraging, especially when you first start working out, if you haven't been working out, because your body naturally fluctuates. So your body could 1 minute drop 6 pounds, and then the next day you could show that you're 10 pounds heavy, you know, especially if you're carrying a lot of weight. Your body goes through these little metamorphoses and changes. So if you babysit the scale and you look at the scale every couple hours or every day, you're going to end up psyching yourself out and psychologically hurting yourself, because you're expecting a bunch of results instantaneously, and that's not how it works. So I use that to liken it to this. Instead of, if you're trying to lose weight, set yourself a goal and then, you know, get to your target weight. Monitor little things in your head and then lose the weight. That's it. You know, if you go look at the scale hour upon hour or every other day or every day or whatever too frequently, we'll put it that way, then it's only going to be discouraging. So for me, Joshua Fury, Eddie Hearn keeps talking and doing interviews and trying to give people hope. You have 30 days from a couple weeks ago to get this fight done. I keep seeing interviews and headliners that say investors or they're calling me nonstop. They want this fight and the target is June, July, but we're not hearing no updates. We haven't heard one real shred of real evidence that Joshua and Fury will be fighting next. None. So Eddie Hearn and, you know, Team Fury and all this stuff, they could say they're targeting June and July. They could say, oh, we're ready to sign contracts. They could say, oh, Wembley has a shot. Fans do not care about any of that. What fans care about is you announcing the fight. That's it. We don't need to be there for every waking moment. You know, it's like you look in basketball right now, the NBA, they have a lot of crazy trades going. They don't need to converse with the fans to trade Chris Paul. They'll just trade Chris Paul. The decision, the deal is all facilitated and the fans just find out about it through a leaked mole in the form of a rumor or when the deal is already done. That's not what we're getting here. You got people who are representing Anthony Joshua or Tyson Fury, and they keep telling you that the fight is coming and Eddie Hearn is the main culprit at the moment. But there's no real update. There's no real update. He can't tell you anything concrete. He, first of all, he's not even involved in the arbitration process. So that alone lets me know that he is not qualified to actually speak on behalf of Tyson Fury's next move because he doesn't manage Tyson Fury, nor is he in court. Because Bob Arum has said that Wilder had no legal recourse, but you're currently in a legal proceeding with Wilder. So that can't be true. So Eddie Hearn has no jurisdiction and no influence, and he might not be privy outside of secondhand information as to what, especially when they have like NDAs and gag orders for a lot of pending trials and public or private, you know, arbitrations and stuff like that. So how would Eddie Hearn, who's doing a lot of the interviews and saying, oh, Wembley's a thought and all this stuff, how would he even know if Fury's even free to fight when he's in litigation and in the arbitration with Wilder? So it just, it's a bad look for boxing because fans don't care about juggling that. They just want to hear when the fight is so they can buy their tickets, buy the pay-per-view, or buy merchandise if it's a fight that they truly want to see. All this other stuff is not hyping up the fight. It's only frustrating fans, and you're actually having the opposite effect. It's similar to if you break up with a girl and you know you messed up, your best thing is to let her know you messed up and say, hey, if you change your mind and, you know, want to reach out to me, do that and let her walk. No contact. That's the best thing you could do, because if you keep calling her and hitting her up and showing up at her job with lunch and she already broke up with you, you're making yourself look like a wimp. You're making yourself look very weak and meek and feeble. And you're just reaffirming the decision that she made to break up with your dumbass. So I think that's the same thing. You know, in life, sometimes when you go, like even what you put out in the universe, if you don't want to be broke and you're tired of being broke and you put out negative energy about being broke, that's what the universe is going to give you back. I truly believe that. You know, you have to change your mindset and have a pure and optimistic mindset and an abundance mindset, and then you'll receive that, you know, if you really firmly believe it. So life will show you that oftentimes when you do the wrong things, the thing you don't want to happen, you'll actually have happen. The thing you want to happen, the opposite will happen. And I think this is a case. What Eddie Hearn and everybody involved is trying to do, they're trying to build up a buzz and generate investors to purchase the fight or whatever by trying to make this a big fight with Joshua Fury, but you're actually doing the exact opposite and not making it a big fight, and you're making it look like a mockery because you keep talking about it and there's, you know, publications and boxing articles and writers who are writing about it with no real evidence to really update. Just imagine if you had a friend who was shot and killed 4th of July of last year, and then you want an update from the cops, and it's been a year or nearly a year, and they really have no true updates to give you. Do you even want to keep hearing from the cops if they can't provide you anything like, hey, we got a couple suspects, or we ruled this person out? If they have no real evidence or no real updates to give you, you know, who wants to hear a bunch of information that doesn't lead them further to, like, closer to the truth? And I think, again, that's what's happening here with Joshua Fury. You're just turning people off from the fight and its legitimacy by having a bunch of fake news and trying to hype people up for a fight that may not happen. And as more time passes, the less I become optimistic that this fight will be next. Tyson Fury was already complaining about inactivity. He hasn't fought since February last year. He's coming off a pandemic. He has like a kind of a weird personality where a lot of people believe he abuses his body, puts poison into his body and stuff like that. Does he even want to come off of a pandemic and like basically almost like a house arrest where people are confined to their homes and then have a fight with Anthony Joshua? Is that really the wise next move for him? You know what I mean? So at the end of the day, we'll see how it pans out. I want to see the update. I don't really care about all these little articles that really don't tell you much. You know, a bunch of articles that say, oh, well, what if this happens? And what if Wembley? And we got 1,000 investors. Nobody cares about any of that if it isn't happening. Period. Let me know what you guys think. We working. So if you enjoyed this video and want more content like this on the channel, you can show your appreciation by going to the PayPal donate button or the YouTube support button, and you can donate any amount that you feel is equivalent to the value of this video. Much more to come. Thank you guys for your support. Boxing Ego, the future of boxing.